Hello everyone, welcome to the analysis for general awareness section for NABARD Grade A 2019. The phase 1 examination is over and I hope you have done or given your best in the examination. The phase 2 examination is about to happen in a month. And in this video, I'm going to analyze the questions and what expected questions could come in the coming examinations like the RBI Grade B examination, the SEBI examination. So you should be aware about these general awareness questions. Reason being, you cannot skip the current affairs section in any examination. So these current affairs questions give you an edge over the other students who are giving the examination. Therefore, it's important to cover these current affairs. Now, if you have covered the last 5 to 6 months current affairs or you have gone through the spotlight for the current affairs, in fact, you have just gone through the morning tales for these current affairs, then it would have been very easy for you to attempt these questions. As the general awareness section was easy to moderate, so 17-18 questions were directly from the spotlight. So in this video, I'm going to tell you why you shouldn't be focusing on one or two questions and you should be focusing on the rest of the 17-18 questions. So who is the present chairman of LIC? Now the appointments question. So it's very important to cover the important appointments for the duration. Reason being, one or two questions can come in the examination related to appointments. So whatever the organization, the banks which are there in the news, you should be aware about their recent appointments. So the LIC question is expected as it's in news related to IDBI Bank. So the present chairman of LIC is M.R. Kumar. Moving on to the next question. So which Indian women cricketer has been named as the goodwill ambassador of Team India at the Street Child Cricket World Cup? Very easy question and very important question as well. Expected question. So Mithali Raj is the answer for this question. So it is out of the sports section. So you should be covering the sports sections as well. Now coming to this Paisa portal. So this Paisa portal was actually launched in 2018 and it was launched in November 2018. So this Paisa portal stands for the Portal for Affordable Credit and Interest Subvention Access, and it is under the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So the question was related to the web portal which has been launched by Allahabad Bank. So a question which can come in the examination regarding the CEO of Allahabad Bank, or it can come regarding the headquarter of Allahabad Bank. So it's important that you know about these answers as well. Moving on to the next question. So which company has been conferred with the non-life insurance of the year award 2019 by ASSOCHAM? Important. So Bharti AXA General Life Insurance is the answer of this question. I hope you have marked Bharti AXA General Insurance. Next is the book Celestial Bodies has been written by. So direct question was not asked related to the Man Booker International Prize. So the news was that the Man Booker International Prize 2019 was awarded to the first Omani writer, and Zoka Alahati is the first Omani writer who has been given this Man Booker International Prize. But the author of the book, so she was awarded for this Celestial Bodies which she has written, and therefore the question come indirectly related to this. So the question came was the book Celestial Bodies has been written by. So keep this thing in mind when the awards are given for some books. So you should be aware about the name of the books, the writers of the books and the award. The next is, who is the present External Affairs Minister? S. Jayashankar is the answer of this question. Also, other questions which can be come in another examination. So they can ask you about the Jal Ministry. They can ask you about the Jal Minister as well. Or they can ask you about the HRD Minister as well. They can ask you about the Home Affairs Minister as well. Reason being, the cabinet has been recently shuffled and new ministers have been appointed. So the new ministers which have been appointed, question can come on those as well. So what is the name of the Jal Minister? So he is Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. And why this ministry is important? Because it has been recently formed by merging two ministries. I've already discussed about these in the morning tales. Now the HRD Minister. So who is the current HRD Minister? The answer is Ramesh Pokhriyal. He is the current HRD Minister. Who is the Minister of Home Affairs? So Amit Shah is the answer. So new ministers which have been appointed. So the cabinet ministers can be asked in the examination. Next being, which country launched the Ravana 1 satellite? So, Sri Lanka is the answer of this question. And with Sri Lanka, there was one Nepali Sat-1 satellite, which is the first satellite of Nepal. Next is exercise Mitra Shakti 6 is held between India and which? So, it's very important to remember the military exercises which are being conducted between India and other countries. So, for example, there are many exercises. So, Maitri, Surya Kiran, Indra, Yudh Abhyas, Sampriti. So these are some of the important exercises. So India and Thailand conducts Maitri. Surya Kiran is between India and Nepal. This is India and Russia, India and US, Sampriti with Bangladesh. So these exercises can be asked in the examination. Also, there was one news related to Sea Vigil. So, Sea Vigil was the exercise and first of its exercise, which was the largest exercise, coastal defense exercise conducted between Navy and the Coast Guard. So, question can come on this as well in the upcoming examination. So, remember these things as well. Moving on to the next one. So, Academy Award 2019 for Best Actor Male, Oscars, the Cannes Film Festival. These are important awards. So whenever Oscars are announced, there is a trend that the question comes on the Oscars award. So the question was related to Best Actor Male. Rami Malek is the answer for that question. The next is the which card has been launched for multi-purpose objectives. So this card, One Nation, One Card, was in news many times. In fact, in 2019 and 2018 both. So expected question. So, which state has taken this step to control West Nile? So, many diseases were there in the news this year and last year as well. So, a question was expected out of diseases as well. So, which state has taken this step to control West Nile virus? So, Kerala is the answer of this question. And the West Nile virus is caused due to Culex mosquito. So, the next question is MD of Truecaller for India operations. Now, this is one of the questions which I was talking about, that one or two questions which you should not be focusing on. The reason being, these questions are not important at all and they shouldn't be asked in the examination. Reason being, you have to focus or you have to be very thorough with the news to answer these questions, and these are not a very direct questions as well. So Truecaller is a private company, and the private companies by every month you would come across the news that they have appointed the CEO or MD, and it's practically impossible to remember the MD and CEO of every private company. So there were many appointments in the same month in May 2019. So this was related to May 2019 and we haven't covered in the spotlight as well. So Spotlight is exhaustive with so much information, so much important information, that students are even complaining that it's not easy to remember everything, and they have other notes as well to remember. So if we are covering, so we'll be covering the private companies as well, then it will become impossible for you to remember any appointments. And there were many other important appointments in the month of May. So the news regarding the first independent director of BSC, that was important, the first women independent director. Another news was the first women referee who has been appointed. So these were the other important appointments in the month of May which should have been asked in the examination rather than focusing on the private appointment. So therefore, it's very important that you have to filter between the important news and the non-important news, and you shouldn't be focusing on these one or two questions, rather focusing on the other 17-18 questions. Next is Indira Grah Jyoti Yojana is associated with which state? So this is associated with Madhya Pradesh. Nothing much to discuss. The state specific scheme and important as well. Next is which country has launched the world's first wireless electric car charging stations? Norway is the answer. It was expected. So whenever there are world's first or India's first, remember those things as well. Which IT company has partnered with the Department of Post to modernize a network of more than 1.5 lakh post offices in the country? Very, very important question. So I remember when I was discussing about this question, I told you the whole news about this question, where TCS is partnered with IT companies to provide this modernized network. So Tata Consultancy Service was answer. Next is, which country has tested the world's first armed amphibious drone boat? Important and expected. The name could have been asked also. So, marine lizard is the answer of this. Or marine lizard is the name and China is the answer. Next is, which state has started the Andata Sukhibhava scheme? So, it was in the budget 2019, the state-specific budget of Andhra Pradesh. And it was related to farmers' welfare. The answer is Andhra Pradesh for this question. Next is, UN has awarded Kanyashri scheme. Which state in India has started this scheme? So, the original news was regarding the award which has been given by UN to two Bengal schemes, the Utkarsh Bangla scheme and the Sabut Sathi scheme. And simultaneously, it was given in the news that Kanyashri scheme was already awarded with this UN award and it's associated with West Bengal. So, question can come on this Utkarsh Bangla and Sabut Sathi scheme as well. The next is, Prime Minister Narendra Modi declared April 2019 to March 2020 as the which of the following year? So, construction technology year was the answer of this question, as there was this conference which was held in New Delhi. In this conference, it was announced that April 2019 to March 2020 is the construction technology year. So, these are the memory based questions. There can be a little heavy in these questions. So, if you have proper questions, you can mention them in the comment section. So, the last questions are, new railway zone for Andhra Pradesh, Southern Coast Railway Zone, has been inaugurated, created, and the headquarters of the same will be in Vishakhapatnam. The answer was Vishakhapatnam for this question. So, it was announced by the Union Railway Minister Piyush Goyal. So, as the general awareness section was easy to moderate, so 15 to 16 questions could have been easily answered if you are regular with the current affairs. We'll be coming up with the next analysis for the ESI and AID section as well. So, stay tuned for those videos and start preparing for the phase 2 examination. Thank you so much for watching the video.